Commissioner, in your opening remarks, you talked about educational experts, both nationally and in the state, that support the Common Core, that think it's the right way to go for our state and other states in the country. I have to tell you, Commissioner, what myself and I think my colleagues are hearing and what you're hearing today is, you know, we're hearing from educational experts too, people who are, for the most part, almost natural adversaries when it comes to some issues in the field of education. I'm talking about school superintendents, principals, school administrators, parents, PTA groups, classroom teachers, most importantly. But they all seem to be united in their opinion of the Common Core. You know, Chairman Flanagan, Chairperson Nolan in the other house have talked about, you know, the flaws in this program as it's been rolled out here in the state of New York. The Teacher of the Year, who I'm sure you're probably gonna be giving some award to this, you know, sometime, happens to teach in my district. She's the Teacher of the Year, classroom teacher. She testified at a hearing that we held in Western New York about the flawed rollout of this system. So to me, you know, those are experts that we are hearing from. Now, Commissioner, to be very frank with you, the people who seem to be supporting this are yourself and the members of the Board of Regents. The governor has talked about a flawed rollout. We're talking about a moratorium. Senator Flanagan has legislation. The governor in his budget message talked about, you know, having a moratorium at least from kindergarten to the second grade. I mean, so I'd like you to comment on those issues and at least talk about the differences between the experts that you are hearing from, that we are not hearing from, and the experts that we are hearing from, the classroom teachers.
Yeah. Again, I think I try and distinguish between the standards and disagreements about implementation. So the Education Conference Board, which is made up of superintendents, school boards, teachers union, administrators association, school business officials, PTA, put out a position paper a short while ago talking about their strong support for the standards and their hope for successful implementation of the standards over time and making recommendations for adjustments to the implementation, many of which we are working on at the department and that we are committed to, all of which we're working on at the department in some form in which we're committed to. Adjustments around investments in professional development and in the resources that districts need to successfully implement the Common Core, adjustments around assessment, so forth. So I would say I think there's continued, across the country and the state, continued support from educators for the standards, even as there are disagreements about implementation, and we have to acknowledge that many of the disagreements about implementation are tied to disagreements about the teacher and principal evaluation law. All of that said, on K through 2, we don't give state standardized tests in K through 2, traditional standardized tests in K through 2. Our position is that we shouldn't have those. And so we agree with the effort to try to address K through 2 traditional standardized testing and to make sure that any assessment that's done in K through 2 is more about observing students, talking with them, talking with them about a book, talking with them about numbers in ways where the assessment is appropriate to that age level.